Welcome back to block three, adding the unexpected. This week's block is called a double monkey wrench. Go figure that one. It's more commonly called churn dash, which is supposed to represent a butter churn. Can't figure that one either. Well, that's just kind of a plain block, isn't it? We'll have to fix that after we did all that good stuff on the applique block. We'll do something different. And we're going to start out by measuring a 6-inch square 2 inches in from both sides. And we're doing that measuring so we can press in folds. So you can either mark it with a friction pen that will come out, or you can just clip the edges, and fold it in half. Just make sure that you don't use a blue or air erasable marker and then press it, because it won't come out. So here it is after the friction pen and after the pressing. Now we're ready for the next step. With the right side facing you and it being folded, you're going to stitch 1/2 inch from the fold. Repeat this process for the second fold on this piece of fabric. From the wrong side, press these seams open by pressing the folds to one side. Not only is this treatment unexpected, but so is the tool we're going to use. We need to press these pleats flat. So by inserting a number 2 pencil in that fold, we are able to press it flat just that easy. Now, if you get to the end and you didn't catch it all, that's not a problem. Just going to turn it around, insert your pencil one more time, push it down flat, and press. Do that to both pleats. Now here I'm misting it with a little bit of water so that I get a good steam and I get real crisp pleats. That's real important for the next step. Now, using the same method of marking that you used before, mark in 2 inches from one end and another 2 inches from that line. And we're going to repeat the same process going the opposite direction. With the right side down, fold it back along that marked line and press. Now let's go to the other marked line and repeat the same process. Make sure you keep the existing pleats flat as you're doing the pressing. Once again at the machine, stitch 1/2 inch from the folded edge. Now when you go over the pleats that you had done previously, make sure they're laying flat. Repeat this same process for the second pleat. Now it's time to press those seams flat again, but because we have that added thickness of the first pleat in there, we don't need to use the pencil. We're able to push it down flat because of the added stiffness. Repeat the same pressing method with the second pleat. Once again, I'm going to mist it because I'm not using a steam iron. I'm just using a fine mist of water so that I can really set those pleats good and firm. It's now time to square up our blocks. We're going to start out by putting the 45-degree diagonal line right through the center of your square and trim off one side. We're going to turn the block around and repeat the same process. Okay, this time we're going to make sure that we're sitting at 3.5 inches on both sides and the diagonal square is still sitting in the middle of your block. Now on for the rest of the block. We're going to take our 2 8-inch squares, place them right sides together, and now we're ready to stitch. And this time, unlike the last lesson, we are going to stitch the perimeter of the square, stitching in 1/4 inch seam all the way around the square. Oops, you're not quite there yet, Jean. Let's do one more stitch so that we can get 1/4 inch. There you go. And we'll continue on. Our last lesson left us with a little controversy over why I didn't have you putting the squares of fabrics together and stitching around the outer perimeter and then cutting it diagonally. I tried to explain to you the reasoning was because it was such a large block, it gave us too much exposure to stretching of the bias edges. This is a smaller block, so we're going to go ahead and use it here. But you'll notice I've already starched it once. And just to be on the safe side, I'm going to add some more spray starch to it to try to prevent the bias edges from stretching. Now we're going to cut it from corner to corner. In one direction. And we're going to cut it again, corner to corner, in the other direction. And when we open it up, we will have our 4 3.5-inch half square triangles. Make sure you square these up to 3.5 inches. Next, we're going to cut one strip each of your background fabric and your fabric of choice. And we're going to stitch those together with a 1/4 inch seam. And then we're going to trim out 4 3.5-inch sections. So now we have all the pieces to our block. And we're going to lay them out like this. And then we're going to start to assemble them. Make sure that you have the points going in the correct orientation. Now we can start to arrange these for sewing. And we're going to do that by pinning the appropriate edges together for the top row, the middle row, and the bottom row. You want to make sure that you don't switch things around, that you keep everything oriented just the way it was when it was laying down in front of you. And you won't have any problem at all. You won't have to get out the unsewer, which we all hate doing. You don't have to be accurate with your pinning. Right now, it's just a placement from when we get to the machine. So we're just going to make sure that we have it put together, right sides together, the way we're going to be sewing it. On the edge, the pin is basically marking the edge we're going to sew on. Now that that's done, let's go to the machine. Here we have our top row all stitched together with a quarter of an inch seam, followed up with the middle row with a quarter of an inch seam on both sides. And last but not least, the bottom row stitched together on both sides with a quarter inch seam. Now it's time for pressing. First, we're going to set the seam by just pressing down flat on it. And next, we're going to press the seam away from the center block. Now on rows 1 and 3, or the top and bottom, we're going to do the same thing by setting the seams first. But now we're going to press the seam towards the center. This will give us nice nesting seams when it comes time to put the block together. Now it's time to stitch those rows together. Let's stitch the top to the middle row. And you'll notice I only have pins where the seams meet up. That's one seam down, and it's looking pretty good at the matching points. Now let's work on the next seams that we need to put in. So we're going again, we're going to pin at the seam line. And right now we're putting together the middle section, which is already attached to the top section. And now we're adding the bottom. Again, pinning just at the seam line to make sure that they're matched up. And we're going to begin stitching. Make sure you have your ends together correctly. Now I want to point out something to you. Do you see that edge? You see how we had a little ruffling? That's what happens when you have biased edges. Now that wasn't so bad because it's such a small piece that I could just finger hold it down and get it eased in. But can you imagine if you had something like that on the big blocks? Now do you understand why I didn't have you do it in this method? It made you do it in a little bit longer method. It worked out much better that way. Down to the stretch, and there's our final block. All it needs now is a good pressing and we'll be done. You want to square this up to 9.5 inches. So what have we done so far? Well, we did the applique block number 1. Then we cut 4 5-inch squares, 6 5 by 9.5-inch squares. We did 7 quarter square triangles, followed by 10 flying geese, and then 64 mini quarter square triangles, followed by block 3. Boy, we've got a lot done. And now you can stitch rows 1 and 2 together. Use a 1/4 inch seam allowance and press to the dark side.